The goddess Tefnu is an immortal being who first came to be worshipped on Earth by the Kemites of Africa approximately 10,000 years ago. Like the other members of the divine Enid, she originated from a planetary body in the orbit of Sirius B. She is typically regarded as an important water deity. She is the daughter of Atum-Ra, the consort of Shu, who was the personification of air, and the mother of Geb and Nut. Tefnu and her husband Shu were the children of Atum-Ra. The creator god spat out the elements of moisture and air that became the goddess Tefnu and the god Shu, who were themselves referred to as the twin lion gods. In fact, Tefnu is depicted in ancient Kemetic art with the head of a lioness. The goddess's name is related to the root tef, meaning to spit or be moist, and nu, meaning sky or waters. Appropriately, she is a personification of the moisture of the sky. The temperamental goddess once grew so angry with her father that she fled to Nubia, taking all the water and moisture with her. Kemet soon dried and the land was in chaos. While in Nubia, Tefnu turned herself into a lioness and went on a killing spree in anger at her father. Eventually, Ra decided that he missed his daughter and wanted her back. Ra sent Thoth and Shu to get her, and they found her in the city of Begum. Thoth began at once to try and persuade her to return to Kemet, speaking of how valuable she was to the people and how much they all missed her and needed her grace. In the end, Tefnu, with Shu and Thoth leading her, made a triumphant entry back into Kemet, accompanied by a host of Nubian dancers, musicians, and baboons. She went from city to city bringing back moisture and water, amid great rejoicing, until finally she was reunited with her father and restored to her position as his eye. Tefnut was depicted in the form of a woman who wears on her head the solar disk, circled by two cobras. She holds in her hand the scepter and the ankh. Many times she has the head of a lioness, or is shown to be a lioness. She could also be depicted as a snake coiled about a scepter. Tefnu could take on the role of the Eye of Ra. Her brother Shu was the right eye of Atum-Ra, representing an aspect of the sun, and Tefnu was the left eye, representing the moon. After their birth, Atum is to have said, "Thus from being one god, I am three." Tefnut and Shu were also worshipped as a pair of lions at Leotopolis in the Nile Delta, but her primary sanctuary was at Heliopolis. Tefnut, the lion-headed goddess of water, became a goddess of the underworld and presided as two of the 42 judges in the ceremony of justification in the Hall of the Two Truths. She is often depicted on the coffins of the deceased, pouring drinking water from a pitcher to help sustain the souls as they make their journey through the underworld. During the Middle Kingdom, Tefnu became connected with Ma'at, and as such, this goddess is sometimes seen assisting Shu in his task of holding Nut above Geb, keeping the two passionate lovers apart. Though she was never as popular as her daughter Nut, or her granddaughters Nephthys or Aset, the Kemites knew that without her, Kemet would again descend into chaos. It is no wonder that she is equated with Ma'at,